change of plans. We're gonna do a full dress right now. Go, go.
Dinner?
Oh, dinner, sorry. I'm huh? Fine.
States to get married. I'm going there to do my MBA. Yes. Who told you this? Yeah. I'm leaving tonight. But I'll be back. Yeah, I'll be back during the holidays though. Yeah. Sure, I'll come visit. I'll miss you too. Okay. Bye-bye. I'll see you there.
Hello? Hey, bro. Yeah.
Yeah, you need to go on.
What? The convent.
To become a nun. Bro, this is Dominique we're talking about. She couldn't become a nun. I know. Okay, who told you this? Eileen. All right, just give me a sec. I'll call you back, okay? I'll call you back.
All right.
First time.
It's my irritating butler. I love you. Don't do anything stupid.
Harold!
Don't do anything stupid. I love you.
Harold, we can't miss this flight.
I'm coming. Just give me a sec.
Harold, we gotta go now!
Exactly! Exactly! mother who insisted that you keep the name. It was her choice. All their plan was to be for 9 months.
Yes, she persuaded me to come to JB for 9 months to have the baby delivered. They should bring the baby up as my baby brother. And no one would know the shameful story.
Well, come keep the baby now. Now that your mother. What is it here anymore? You have the choice of marrying the father of the baby, Dominique. Why did you not tell us who the father was?
It would be unfair to him. He's gone to the States. It would ruin his career if he got married.
Ah, well, welcome, Miss Dominique Joseph. And your beautiful baby. What was his name?
Harry Vernon! Harry Vernon!
Again?
Harry Vernon!
That's a nice name for a strong, beautiful child.
Bye-bye, my baby! I love you! Sorry, Daddy. Please forgive me.
Dominique! Walk and learn this very painful lesson. And never disobey me again. You will overtake the mistress soon. You only wasted 9 months in the maybe. It was all for you, Dominique. I have only one child, and everything is for you. Your mother and I had such high hopes for you. If we knew you wanted to get pregnant, to get baby, and to start a family, then marry you off to a good bro.
No, Daddy, I don't want to get married. I'm going to be rich and successful. Nobody's going to stop me.
Well, you're not going to get pregnant. You're not going to get married. Hope you won't get pregnant again.
Proud of
me,
Daddy. Okay. Off.
Out.
Monster,
seriously.
Off.
Did he last?
Yeah,
okay,
I'm last. Did he come down? Yeah, got
to.
Off.
He's much better than this.
Stop it and move!
Ooh.
And 1, 2, 3. Sound.
And the cleverest, right?
I also remember last time
your grandma used to come. She, you make her eat the cupcakes made of Play-Doh.
But
she pretended to eat, you know?
She pretended to eat them? She told me it was nice. That's why when she asked me what I want to become when I grow up, I say I want to become a chef and be on TV and teach everyone how to cook and make proper. Hey, Majib, it's not cupcakes, it's kueh lapis. How can you confuse it?
I wish I could see
all the
right now.
Yeah.
I wish I could see
you all. It's okay, you cannot see, but know what? I made something special.
No,
cupcakes. Kueh lapis, Majib. Seven colors can see from outside, cupcakes cannot see one.
Cannot see.
You can still taste the flavors though. Each flavor is different. Very nice. What's wrong, Machi? Nice, right? Machi, hold on.
Hello?
Yes, yes. Yes, the ingredients are right in front of me. The onions, the prawns, and everything. Okay, I know today's important. So what? Okay, dominatrix onto me. I know, I'm coming. Magic.
Today's a very, very special episode, so enjoy the kueh lapis. I have to rush off and I'll get nurse room to push you back to your bed, okay? Did you eat the kueh lapis?
Later.
Very nice, you know, got apple, orange, every flavor also have. I don't need to go now, huh? Take care, okay? Let's walk! Miss Wong, I need to go, so please send her back to her. Machi?
Hello.
Is it you, Miss Wong?
It's not Miss Wong. I'm the manager from the store down the road, and I just wanted to ask you a few questions about this place.
Ask Machi. Machi know everything about this place. Ask Machi.
How is it that this place is an old folks' home now? It used to be an orphanage?
Ah, see first. Singaporeans don't give away their children now, you know?
They give away all their children.
But what do you want to ask?
You've been here very long.
Yeah.
Close?
Yeah, Machi know everything about this place. Very long already. You know, just now, got one small boy come to visit me.
You mean the Chinese man?
Yeah, the Chinese boy.
He was an orphan here?
Hmm.
So you remember every child?
Machi think so lah, but now Machi blind already. What do you want to ask?
There must have not been many boys today.
Ah yeah, got a lot of girls, you know. Got Chinese, Eurasian, Indian girls also got. Very poor thing, you know, these girls.
Boys?
Very poor thing, these girls.
Boys?
Boys got seven only. Five Chinese boys, two Indian.
2 million boys, you say?
Mm.
What happened to them?
I only remember one. Come closer. He was adopted when he's 6 months old by his relatives in Cochin. You know what? They're very rich, you know? His parents too poor already. Seven sons born to them.
Wait, you said two Indian boys? What happened to the other one?
I don't know.
Why?
I don't remember.
You said you remember every child.
Miss, may I ask who are you?
I think you already know who I am.
These hands. You the Indian boys?
Mother.
Miss
Dominic Joseph. You must not tell anyone I was here.
I won't tell anyone.
Please tell me what happened to him.
I cannot.
Why? What happened to him?
Your father.
My father?
Your father made us promise to not tell you anything about the boy.
You know your father donated $2 million.
He bribed you?
No, he donated $2 million the day you and your boy came here. He paid for the boy's entire education, you know?
Has he ever asked about me?
No, your boy never asked about you.
That's good. I mean, we are successful now. We couldn't afford that.
You have a family now, is it?
Thank you for your information.
What's this?
Money.
No. Put it in the donation box over there.
Where?
Right at the bed. Come, I'll show you where.
You can walk?
Can, I'm only blind. How much you put in now?
50?
100?
200.
Ah, can.
Went to the kitchen. For what? A glass of milk.
Three.
She had three glasses of milk, yes. You must be so proud of her, right, Auntie?
Huh?
She's getting so fat, Auntie. I don't know why. What?
Full cream. Yes, she's drinking full cream milk, Auntie.
Just the way you like it, yeah.
What? Today? Tomorrow? Sure, I'll tell her.
Done. What was she talking to you about?
What was she talking to me about? She was asking if you drank the milk. And I said, yeah. You know what? I'm listening, right? So,
I know she'll ask you that, but she seemed to be talking about something else.
She did. Yes, she did. You know what she was asking? She was asking if I'd make a good husband for you.
Harry.
Really?
Harry.
Really?
I'm sure you'll make a great husband. For some dicky ahead.
Spicy, you know. I like it. Okay, look, hear me out. You know, I can cook, right? Marry me, you won't have to peel an onion or wash a plate or make chai, coffee for the rest of your life. For the rest of your life, Rumini. Huh? Huh? Huh?
What did Mama really want?
What did your Mama really want? She's asking when my parents are going to ask yours for your hands in marriage. It's going to happen soon, Rumini. And you know it. No. My camera, Rohini, it's not a painting. Please put it down.
No.
Okay, Amma was saying that she ordered six boxes, six doubles of Amul full cream milk, and they'll arrive tomorrow. Delivery! That's all!
You should have just told me this earlier.
Just playing around.
Anyway, I'm off now. Okay. You'll be home tonight.
Why? Yeah, I will be.
I'll be home tonight.
You will?
I will.
You will?
Of
course you see. After the
show? Yes, I will.
Oh, no.
Thank you.
we are very excited because we are coming to you live for the very first time from DJ Production Studios.
And I'm Jay. Are you ready for the next meal?
Great. Today is a very special day.
Why?
How can you not know it's the 50th episode of The Rojack Show?
Wow! Roy, I would like to thank each and every one of you who's been supporting us here for the past 49 weeks.
Yes, we could not have done this without your support and enthusiasm.
Those of you present here... Yes. Those of you present here and those of you back at homes with your little notebooks, scribbling down whatever you're trying to say, telling us that what we're saying is important, telling us that we are important and that we matter. And now,
are you ready for yet another delicious dish on this special 50th episode of The Rojack Show?
Yes. Are you ready for seafood?
Are you ready for prawns?
Are you ready for king prawns?
Great! Today's very special specialty is a contribution from Mrs. D. Souza, who hails from Singapore!
Balas Ramadan Shiva Ramakrishna.
How dare you!
What? What? You dumb dominatrix? What? I'm fired, so what?
Just you fired too!
No!
Get out of my
no! Dominic!
What?
Give me one more chance.
No more chances for you.
Please, I have an idea.
Why it over?
What is it? A new talk show!
Not another talk show!
Please, you will work out, I promise you.
You have 15 seconds to prove your worth, or you will be removed from my building in 5 separate trash.
Okay, we'll feature Singapore writers and artists. We'll involve your audience as well. You know how nobody thinks literature at school these days? Well, maybe they might go again and retreat! What's happening?
Please!
Yes, on your feet, Cody! Stand over there!
Tissue, now. One last chance.
Bro, shoes. Don't forget your shoes. I like the shoes inside.
Ro. Oh, Ro. What will you do without me?
Ro.
Whoa!
Who are you?
Harry
Vanan.
Harry
Vanan, money!
Harry Vanan, Rose roommate.
You
went down your feet, you begged for the new show, and it's not easy to come by. So just go and post your new whatever show.
I had to, okay? I don't have a rich godmother on top like you.
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Hey, don't do me like
that. Wait. Rich godmother?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why?
Toy boy!
I'm a toy boy!
Toy boy! Three plays with you every day.
I'm an orphan! Yeah, and I grew up in an orphanage when I was 7 years old. You know the stories? My aunt came to get me, and she's like my mom too. God got me, okay? And I'm not anyone's toy boy.
Yeah, what, Jack?
What?
Joanie is very lucky, you know why?
Why?
She's the orphan that got adopted, and I'm the orphan that didn't.
You're an orphan?
I'm an orphan.
No one came to claim you?
No. What about Roy? No.
What? Ah! Roy!
Yeah, you son of a...
Yes, you son of nobody! What I can always say, man, when we come claim you?
I'll claim insanity first.
Oh, you know what, Ro? Insanity is his last name.
Yeah! Claim him! Insanity, Vanan!
Why are you taking his side and ganging up on me, Jack?
Oh, lady, I'm not ganging up on you, okay? Because we are brothers.
Yes.
Brothers forever.
Money. Cheeky shouts. Vanan got the money and cheeky's got the chops. Money and cheeky chops. Dancing to the mountain top.
Is that some song I'm supposed to know about?
No. It's my song with Money Bunny. Why do you know that song?
Song with Cheeky Chops. That's how it goes.
I'm Cheeky Chops.
Here, Jack.
Wait, hold on. So, are you the Cheeky Chop that you've been talking about? And are you the Money Bunny that you've been talking about?
You're Money Bunny.
Hold on, let me confirm.
What?
Money!
I got it,
you!
One day, a distant relative of mine came, okay? He came and he dropped in a lot of money to the orphanage. Alright? And you know what? He paid for my education also.
Oh.
Well, the money, funny. It's not that funny.
I see.
So,
you're the toy boy.
No?
Toy boy. Money Bunny's a toy boy. Toy boy.
Hey, no, I'm not the toy boy.
Yes,
you are. You know why? He had nothing to do with me. He came, I don't even know if it's a he or she is a she. Came in and left.
But he was happy to be the beneficiary of his
money.
No, generous.
Money.
Thank you.
Cheers, money, money, to be the money, money.
I don't know, maybe. Nice show.
I was there.
Oh.
Money, money. Thank you for what?
Just taking a shower.
Yeah. Sorry for what?
You promised me something.
Yes.
Money.
Let's do it now.
Yes. Money. Yes, yes.
Money.
Oh, what?
She's taking a shower.
I don't care. No.
Don't be scared. Don't be scared.
No, I'm not scared.
Mama's not home. You're always so scared. Don't worry. She says she'll come back tomorrow.
What's wrong with you?
Tomorrow morning. Go. Bro. You wanted a new talk show, right?
You were eavesdropping?
I was trying to make sure you get a new talk.
Yeah, right.
So why don't you put your drawing like this? Godma's a writer and she's quite famous. The Geraldine Song! Or is it for talk shows, radio shows, blah blah blah.
Sounds like a good idea.
It's a good idea, yes. You know what? Let's cheers.
Cheers
to Rohini's successful show.
Do you have a name for this show?
Of course I do.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do. It's going to be called
Dominatrix.
No! Wait for it. It will be called.
Wait. No.
The Literary Show, hosted by Rohini.
Jack!
Shut up!
Jack, shut up!
Really,
it's very
irresponsible.
Jack,
shut up!
I like the show, literally.
Money, Bunny! You don't get this. DJ Production Studio is a prison. And the Dominatrix. She's the cruel prison warden. No! This should be how you start the show. Gina, we are for sin. Welcome to my prison! And I'm your host, Misprision!
Roy! Intermission!
Roy!
Jack! Not again!
What? Jack!
Yes?
Misprision! That's Harold Bloom's theory!
Who's Harold Bloom?
Lord's relative!
Ah, the one that gave you money?
Just!
Bro, it's a bottle of
guys!
What?
He came up with the map of misreading.
Bro, you got compass!
Let's go for the treasure.
I'm going north.
I'm going south.
Jack.
Are you ready? He came up with the map of misreading. And that's what my show is going to be called.
Map of misreading.
No!
Oh, grow!
No! There's going to be creative misreading of many literary works.
Misprision's a word?
Yes.
It is, Jack. Come on.
Misprision.
You know what? Really, you think the Dominatrix will like it?
She will.
Yes.
I think
she will. You know what, Ronnie? She's gonna love it because everyone loves you. I don't know if Jack loves you.
I
like
you
more than Jack.
But yes.
You know what, Ronnie?
But tell me one thing. What is misreading?
I want to be a great misreader.
Ronnie, don't take offense. I really don't know. I'm not that smart.
You don't have to care about that, Harry.
Oh, why?
You just do what you do best.
Oh, I can do you
best. Miss Loving!
I knew you were gonna do that role. High five! And I'll do what I do best.
Hey, an idiot!
The Miss Loving!
Miss Loving! Miss Loving!
Oh, no! Cut it!
Miss Loving, huh? Hey. I've been Miss Loving you all this while.
Not anymore!
No! Harry!
I told you she was
Yo.
What?
You stole my shirt.
Oh, that's my shirt.
I gave it to you.
Thank you. Well, I took your shirt.
Well, you. Why are you in Grandma's Chongzang?
You told me I could take the clothes from the cupboard.
But Grandma doesn't like anyone to be in her.
Why are you wearing your skirt in the first place?
Because you're wearing it.
Out for me. Green, could you skirt out for me?
Ah.
Yes. Don't worry. I got it.
You had a damn good role with him, but you were too drunk to remember.
That's it.
Cool.
Congrats, bro.
Yeah.
And why are you half naked?
No,
no, no. No, we didn't do anything.
We didn't do anything.
I
got it, huh? You had a damn good role with me as well.
Too drunk to
remember. Wait. Hey! What? Threesome?
That's threesome!
Yes, I'm going there. That's what I'm gonna do. Chris is there, right?
Check, please!
You're fine,
Ricky. Sure? Where's the book? Is that the book? The book that we're going to use for the show?
Oh, this is stage.
Come on! I told you I wanted it backstage, not on stage! Stop looking at me like that, it's so creepy! Go get it!
I am shocked myself and at myself.
What are you doing?
Oh, you're looking for the book?
Yes.
Interesting book. Just that I don't understand anything. Shocked myself and
back then, she started a business with a boyfriend, Johnson Cole. And and they call it Ghost Song in the phrase. Anyway, it went on very strong, very well. I think the older audience might know. But you're too young and beautiful to learn. Anyway, what I'm saying is that the business went bankrupt. Ghost Song in the phrase. Ghost Song, Ghost Song. Johnson called this result.
Committed suicide! Yes!
Well, that's not a sad part. Gwen and you found out that she was pregnant with your baby boy.
Pregnant! Pregnant!
She had to give up that baby boy for adoption right after giving birth to him.
Publish a comedy, I'll bite my own shoe.
In my office.
hurry up!
Hurry up, lah!
The specs on the floor.
I pick up, is it? My job.
Theeben, not you.
Pull the curtains. Hey, Bala! Pull the curtains! Hey, crossing one, light!
Set down.
What are you doing in my office?
Sita Lakshmi Devi, Dr. Bala Subramanian, Shiva Ramakrishna. Yes. That is my full name. Rodi Lata Sita Lakshmi Devi, Dr. Bala Subramanian, Shiva Ramakrishna. My father didn't give me such a name for nothing. I'm destined to do great things.
I'm the one destined to do great things!
I am Rohini, a star. I am Rohini, the star.
I am the star!
I'm my own woman. I'm going to be rich and successful, and nobody is going to stop me.
I'm the one to say those things first.
I'm going to be more famous than I already am.
The one who made you famous? I'm the one who made you famous, you ungrateful girl!
It's my destiny. And I'm never getting married. Marriage is for dreamers and idealists. Dreamers and idealists never get anything done. They just dream and waste
away.
Away.
I said those lines first. I did, didn't I? You're
nothing.
Stealing my lines.
Nothing comes between me and my destiny.
Heck, if you want to imitate me so badly, you'll get pregnant and ruined, you Ingrid.
Nothing comes between me and my destiny.
I made you famous, ruining that Masita Lashmi Devi,
Dr. Bala Subramanian. Shiva Ramakrishna is a powerful name. It's the name of three great gods. Shiva, Rama, Krishna. With their blessings, I'm just great success.
I made you famous. If not for me, you'd still be a bloody sales girl at bloody Baker's Bras and Borough Bookstore. If not for me, you ain't great!
I like you.
It'll make me cry.
Monsieur!
You!
I'm sorry for starting a fire!
What fire?
Emergency fire!
No fire! Get up here!
Please forgive me! I will not forgive myself!
Get up! Be a man!
What?
Did you make this?
Oui, I'm sorry!
What is your name?
Jean-Paul Jacques!
Shouldn't be slaving in my restaurant. Your talent is wasted here.
Monsieur, you are mistaken.
Am I?
Yes, in the finest restaurants, such as the ones that you are running here, there are no slaves here, Monsieur.
Well expressed, young man. Well expressed. Tell me now, if there are no slaves, or shall I put it another way, no workers, how do you then explain the perfection of the final product?
Monsieur, the answer is simple. I believe the culinary experience is an aesthetic process. I like to think of it as a theater production. All of us here in the restaurant are the cast and crew of the theater production. We work together to present the grand culinary story to our patrons. The grand culinary narrative.
I have absolutely no idea what you're blabbering about. Look, Jack, here's the thing. Would you give all this togetherness up?
Monsieur, please don't fire me!
No, I'm not gonna fire you. Get up! Get up, you! Be a man! Come, get up! Would you give all this togetherness up to go to the USA with me to host your very own food program?
Host my own food program?
Yes, that's what it said.
Monsieur, I would.
Would? But didn't you just say that it is in the finest restaurant you work together to set the grand culinary narrative? Huh? Why would you now decide to go?
Monsieur! A true artist will gravitate towards the place where his art will be truly appreciated by the greatest number of people. An artist fails. He produces great work, but fails to share it with the world. Monsieur, you look confused.
I am.
I want to make a delicious buffet. And... Oh, if I was to make a delicious buffet and no one get to taste it, it will languish in the fridge and eventually be tested.
Posita's bin. Unappreciator! Travesty!
Calm down. You spot on the nonsense! But nonetheless, it's very convincing.
And that's what TV needs these days.
Dutch-she!
Yes, Dutch-she.
Oui, yes. Look.
So you will come to the U.S. Monsieur, I would like to negotiate on this deal with you if I may, you know.
Negotiations, yes. I am a businessman.
Monsieur.
Come on. Name me your price.
Monsieur, it is not about the money. You have the money, I know. If you would spend so much money to send me to Singapore. Oh, I was trying to say if you could send me to Singapore. It is my greatest dream to host my own culinary program in Singapore.
Singapore.
Okay? Oui.
You don't actually, oui. You can find some production house or studio there. And perhaps, yes, I might.
Monsieur, I have a good friend. She works in a local production.
She, you said?
Oui.
Ah, is she great?
She's beautiful.
Good. Is she sexy?
Sexy.
What is that they use these days? Hot.
Hot.
Oui.
Oui. You wanna see?
Oui, yes.
Monsieur.
Oh. Fine, special.
She works in a. She's an host of a local production.
I can't zoom in any further on this thing.
Unpinch. Monsieur, yes, she is a host of a local production in Singapore, a TV program. Mm-hmm. She's very famous, sir.
But wouldn't she be of competition with us? Huh?
Monsieur, she's a good friend. Which part of good friend do you not understand? She'll be too happy to see me in Singapore.
You know, Jack Shui Wee.
Jack Shui. No.
It's been a while.
Monsieur, you say Singapore too. You've been in Singapore before?
Yes, actually. Oui. I was born there. A very long time ago.
I don't know how I should put this. This. But. I'm from Singapore. I'm from Singapore. Laugh.
And why do you talk funny?
Well, when I applied for a job here, the guy who picked up the phone. Bala! Bala said that I should put on the.
Oh, no!
This guy told me I should put on an accent so the Vitoans would like me.
What nonsense! You should drop the accent! You sound like a goat in heat!
Really?
Good match. Arrange for a meeting.
I could actually call right now back to Singapore and things would. Things would work out.
Go ahead.
Six, five.
How would I know?
Hello?
No.
Hurry. Why are you coming to the phone? Don't tell me you guys are having a damn good roll right now.
Damn good.
So nothing happened. Yeah, you're disgusting. No, don't tell me the detail. Just get Ro to call me back. It's important, so do whatever you guys are doing quickly. Cool.
Yes, that's right.
In fact, it's really urgent. She's busy at the moment.
Yes. Sounds like very, very.
You would love to meet her. She's got the star quality X factor, you may say.
X Factor.
You mean Sex Factor?
Hello?
Ro!
Ro!
Yes, I completely understand you. Wait, are you dressed or are you just standing there and you're starving me and talking to me? Ew, disgusting you. Anyway, deal of century. Hurricane Boss Associates. Yes, the company I'm working with.
Tell I'm rich.
My rich boss.
Tell I'm handsome.
Who is handsome?
Tell I'm abs.
Who has hair?
Abs.
Abs. Would like to hold a culinary program in Singapore. Culinary program. And I will be hosting.
Yes.
And you could go to the studio and get her to agree to it. Just. You might be able to.
Yes. Yeah.
Bye.
Sorry. What?
Sir, just inform you that.
Bala! Could you help me out there?
We are cooking.
Faizzah!
Just in
the
middle of time.
Come!
Old man, get
out
there!
Easy! No!
Climbing up there. Dinner! It's Ariana! My goodness!
Done.
Hey, fighting one! Shut up!
Why is my chair always so low? Who has been sitting up?
Have I ever asked you to take a seat in my office? Didn't think so. What is this?
Hurricane Boss Associate!
What?
Boss Associate!
Sorry, why didn't you? Never heard of them.
They're big in the USA and Europe.
Really? You're a shareholder, Rohini?
No, I work only for you.
Then good. Do your job and let me do mine.
Out!
Oh, Dominic.
Yes?
The
photographer. Harry, he'll be coming to show you his portfolio.
Yes. Do your job and let me do mine.
Out!
Stupid girl. Quit my company over the arrogant balls associated with this.
Hurry!
You still look the same after so many years!
Yes, I can make it.
I'm so sorry. I look the same as Harold, but I'm Hari. Hari, it's not that difficult. Okay, you know what, ma'am? You can call me Harold. I'm Harold. But I have to leave now, so I'm really sorry, babe.
Yes, please. Go after all the medicals and you'll come home.
No, I won't. No, I'm not leaving you. Bye.
What is
wrong?
That's my thing. Rodney! Rodney, you arranged the appointment! Wait! Hurry!
Sit down.
Yourself with lifelike portraits.
Some of them quite ugly.
Oh, yes.
I came back this morning with my final shaft. Jack Shoy Oi. Should meet him. He's very talented. May I sit down?
Yes, please.
Thank you. So, Dominic, when did you leave the convent? Had I known, I would have come back to marry you. Ah, like we promised.
I never went to the convent. I made them. It was a lie.
What? Ah, okay. I got it. There was someone else.
No, Harold. There was no one else.
No one? Why did you lie?
Would you like more?
Oh, yes. After hearing the great news. Definitely.
I found out that I was pregnant.
What?
It was yours.
It was mine. So you didn't go to the convent, you didn't become a nun, and you were pregnant with my child. Oh, oh, oh. Why didn't you tell me this?
If I had told you, you wouldn't have gone to the convent.
Precisely.
Precisely why I didn't tell you, Harold. Father made me go to JD for 9 months, so no one would know the shameful story. But by the time I got back, you were gone. You never came back.
Of course I never came back. You went on to become a nun. Even if I did come back, what chance would I have? It's gone. How is my offspring?
I gave him up for adoption. Yes, Harold.
me your hat.
Tennis.
Ciao, Bob, that's the same.
Doric!
Yes, Harold?
Nurul! Will you marry me? Ouch!
This is beautiful!
Here's got some fire, Topaz, Ruby, you name it, all the jewels! And then one little ring.
You've had this quest and this ring with you all this while?
Yes, Dominique. The question has always been on top of my head.
Not that I want to tally. But would it make economic sense for us to get married? I mean, we have our separate businesses to think about. We are making so much money.
No, think about it. You're successful here, and I am successful worldwide. Can you imagine if we merged? Yes.
Merged.
Merged.
Harold.
Yes.
Merged.
Yes.
So I can bring this.
Oh!
Saint and Nurul?
Yes. You know, Misprision sounds a bit too atos. Make it more friendly and more approachable.
So what do I do with Rohini? Do I fire
her? No, don't fire her. She's got talent.
Yeah, I know, I talent spotted
her. Oh, you've always had an eye for good things.
Beautiful. Oh.
So yes, will you marry me?
The answer is yes. But wait, I have to give her her own show.
Yes. Name it after her.
Like Ellen, or Oprah, or Tyra. A Queen Latifah? Ah. A Kumar!
Yes! The Rohini Show!
Rohini Show!
Yes!
In that case, if I'm going to make a lot of money, yes! I will marry you!
You will marry me!
Yes! Oh, but would you help me put this on?
Oh yes, baby! Give it to me!
Put it on!
Give it to me! It's tight! Oh, so tight, baby!
Yes.
So tight! Oh, baby! Oh,
is it Tyra? Is it Oprah? Is it Ellen? Or is it Kumar? No, it's our very own Rohini! It's the Rohini Show!
Thank you, everyone. Tonight, our guest is the anchor of the American Culinary Night.
Bonjour,
Jacques.
Merci beaucoup. Back in Singapore.
So tell us about your rags to riches deal.
No problem. I was born in Singapore, but I grew up in France. Ah, my father is Singaporean, but my mother is Francaise. And I went to France to study in the Heineken Culinary Institute. And then I came back to Singapore. Oh!
So, why did you decide to
while I was in Singapore, I applied as a host. No, no, as a chef at the Hurricane Boss Fine Diners restaurant in France. And the owner, Monsieur Aero Bosco, was not only too impressed with my cooking. He was too impressed with my personality. He gave me a job as the host of the American Culinary Night in Singapore, and then...
And then, the rest is history. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a surprise for you.
We do.
Welcome back, Jekko!
Brilliant! Brilliant work! Joshua, Orion, Rohini! Come upstairs, I'm opening a bottle of champagne for the both of you.
That's my boss, is the hair boss.
I have not met him. I was gonna wash my face and then I'll yell. Just give me some time.
Oh, man.
Ashamed of. I've always admired you. now that I know about your story, I admire you even more. You mentioned that I'm more sensible than you were when you were my age. But I think you have greater courage than I can ever hope to have. I have learned many things from you, Dominic. You have taught me many lessons in life. So don't be so harsh on yourself. Love yourself, Dominic. You're worth loving. You really are.
Party! 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 guest current call. Faizzah as Vikunto as our stage manager. James Kumar as Harold. Sofia Begum as Dom the Dominatrix. Khatijah Begum as Rohini Lata Sita Chimbili, daughter of Balasubramanian, Shikara Ramakrishnan. Willy Beh as Jacques-Claude, Jacques-Shi, and Geraldine Song. Dianah Song as Machi, Clarissa Tech, and Mrs. D'Souza. Vinay Kumar as Harold, Young Harold. Reuben Dominic as Ruby Dom. Theeben Ramani as Ben. Harry Vanan as Harry. Vemalan as Ba. And also Sarah Begum as our wardrobe mistress. Norek as our makeup artist. Lastly, we will try to win this time and say thank you very much. Alright, Bye. Alterity Production presents Misprision.
Thank you very much and happy Valentine's. Have a good evening.